Bonsoir à tous. I hope you're doing great. It's so lovely to be with you today. It's Wednesday, May the 20th. I have a big cup of tea with me. I hope you have something good. I know that some of you are having breakfast or maybe lunch. I know maybe some people are having dinner if you're in the same time zone as Europe, well, as France. And it's our avant-dernière session for the nanofictions, as I mentioned on Monday, because they're wonderful projects that I want to start working on for Commune Française. You should receive an email about that today because it's on my the biggest thing on my to-do list for today to send you an email about a few options that I'm considering, and I really want your input on that. Yeah, it was such a wonderful thing to do together. I'm delighted, and I hope we do a few more in the future. I don't know what the future is going to bring, but doing this together during these difficult times, which are far from finished, is lovely. So I don't know yet how it's going to be, but again, if this is something that you like. I do that in Le Salon twice a month, and we have such a lovely time. And we had such a lovely time on Monday. So feel free to join us if you wish. Today, it is our 27th session. So if you've been following so far, it is our 54th, no, divided by two. So it is our 13th hour of doing this together. So well done you. You've been learning French for 13 hours and you took lots of notes. I know some of you have made such wonderful progress. I heard Jack was telling me about the passé simple that now he masters. I know some of you have really improved, whether you're a beginner and just went a little bit above. Some of you learned more expressions, more verbs, vocabulary, nouns, culture as well, because we talked about that and it's lovely. So we're going to do two tales together today as usual, because you know what you're doing now, you're experts. Let's start with the first tale. And if this is your first session, we're talking about the Nanofictions by Patrick Beau. I do a reading in French with you out loud. And then I analyze each sentence for the vocabulary, the liaison, everything. Ready? There's a chicken out there. Funny, I can see it from here and listen to it. It's really sunny today in Grenoble. Let's read this together. Breathe in as usual. Breathe out. And one, two, and three, and try to do la liaison because you are so good at it now. Ce chef de guerre avait tué tant d'ennemis qu'il prétendait pouvoir vaincre la mort elle-même. Un jour, elle lui apparut sur un champ de bataille. Tu es venu relever mon défi? demanda-t-il. Non, répondit la mort, j'aime simplement remercier les bons employés. Did you understand what this was about? It's not a very fun one. The other one is about dreaming, but I really like this one as well. Let's reread the first sentence together. Are you ready? One, two, three. Ce chef de guerre avait tué tant d'ennemis qu'il prétendait pouvoir vaincre la mort elle-même. And I think here there is un tiret that is missing. Did you find any liaison? I didn't find any. So I don't think there is any in this sentence. Ce chef de guerre, un chef de guerre, it is a warlord, un chef de guerre. un chef de guerre avait tué. It is had killed. It is le plus que parfait, I think. Plus que parfait. I'm going to check. Plus que parfait. You know, this is the kind of. Okay, yes, indeed. It is the kind of tenses that I never teach because it's sometimes a little bit advanced. So, for example, a tué, it is le passé composé. And when you have this form of imparfait instead of le présent here, it is le plus que parfait. Avait tué. I haven't done a conjugation class in a while. That might be interesting for students. Le plus que parfait. I know I have a course called test your conju Oops, sorry, test your conjugation. And students like it a lot because it's about teaching the conjugation and then giving you a test. But I haven't, it's been a while since I did it, and I haven't done one on the weekly lessons on Tuesday for a while. Le plus que parfait. So you can notice it when l'auxiliaire here, a, it is avoir, is not au présent, it is à l'imparfait. And this is le plus que parfait. And then after that, you add le passé composé. So for killing, tuer, it is tuer, T-U-E, accent aigu. Tant d'ennemis, so many enemies. Tant de, it is so many. Tant de, it is so many. Tant de, so many. And here he could have said tellement. Ce chef de guerre avait tué tellement d'ennemis. égale tellement de ennemis, tellement d'ennemis. Here, obviously, you would put une apostrophe instead of e, okay, because it is exactly the same structure. So many qu'il prétendait pouvoir vaincre la mort elle-même. That he pretended, prétendre has several meanings. Prétendre. He maintained. He claimed. Yes, this is it. He claimed that he could actually do it. He claimed, prétendre. This is the verb, prétendre. To claim that you can do something. Because here it is prétendait pouvoir vaincre la mort elle-même. I'm drinking a little bit of tea. Yesterday I had a live session. I know that Maggie was here. I think Paul was here as well for Exercise Your French, and it took me an hour. And right before that, I did the lesson for. The weekly lesson for yesterday, and I did it in three takes, which because I wanted to test some things, but nothing worked. And at the end of the day, my throat was so dry. So today, during this lesson, I'm trying to drink a little bit so I don't lose my throat. Pouvoir vaincre, vaincre, it is to defeat. And also, if you're talking about someone who was defeated, we say un vaincu. I'm looking for the right translation for you because beaten, the beaten. Okay, defeated, the loser. Okay, but here it's not loser, it is more beaten because we have a more literary use. Un vaincu, la mort elle-même, death herself. Okay, here it is feminine. La mort is always feminine. La mort is death. And la mort as the character that you can imagine all in black with la faucille. La faux, let's say la faux instead. The scythe. Of course. I say of course because Scythe is one of my favorite board games. La mort is death. So it is exactly the same use. La mort, here with a capital M, is the character. With la faux, the scythe. Elle-même, herself. And this is the structure when you want to say herself, himself. And it doesn't add anything to the real meaning of the sentence. It just insists that it really is this famous character. For example, le président lui-même a affirmé, non, let's say est venu, so it's even better, est venu à Grenoble me serrer la main. Okay. The president himself came to Grenoble to shake my hand. Here you could totally say le président est venu à Grenoble me serrer la main, that's perfect. But here you really want to insist on the fact that I could not believe it. So it is the same use as you have in English. Let's repeat the sentence together. One, two, three. Ce chef de guerre avait tué tant d'ennemis qu'il prétendait pouvoir vaincre la mort elle-même. OK, good. Let's move on to the next one. Un jour, elle lui apparut sur un champ de bataille. Tu es venu relever mon défi? Demanda-t-il. Un jour, elle apparut sur un champ de bataille. One day, she appeared, because again, la mort is feminine in French. Un jour, one day, elle lui apparut sur un champ de bataille. Apparaître, it is to appear. And how do you say disappear? Easy, disparaître. Apparaître, appear, disparaître, disappear. Elle apparut sur un champ de bataille. You can notice here. Apparu is le passé simple, obviously. And elle lui apparut, and she appeared to him. Okay. Elle apparut au chef de guerre. And au chef de guerre is lui. Au chef de guerre is lui. Sur un champ de bataille, on a battlefield. Un champ de bataille is a battlefield. And you can use that for other things. For example, un champ de blé. It is a wheat field. That works. It's better than un champ de bataille. And she says, tu es venu relever mon. He says, tu es venu relever mon défi, demanda-t-il. Did you come to. How do you say that? Relever un défi. It is when you want to check on a challenge. Relever un défi. Do we have something good here? Relever un défi, to rise to a challenge. To take up a challenge. So let's use take up a challenge because it is simple. It is closer. Relever un défi. It is to, and of course, my short-term memory, to take up a challenge. To take up a challenge. Relever un défi. And this you can remember because it is how we say it. Relever un défi. Un défi is a challenge. Demanda-t-il, he asked. And again, if this is your first time in nanofictions, this is the way that we express a dialogue. Demanda-t-il, he asked. But we say it with une inversion. Non, répondit la mort. No, answered death. J'aime simplement remercier les bons employés. I'm checking the liaison above. No. And here we have just one. Okay. Non, répondit la mort. No, answered death. J'aime simplement remercier les bons employés. J'aime is I like. Aimer is to like. To love. Remercier is to thank. Les bons employés, good employees. Ready to read it entirely together? Okay. Breathe in, breathe out. One, two, and three. Ce chef de guerre avait tué tant d'ennemis qu'il prétendait pouvoir vaincre la mort elle-même. This warlord had killed so many enemies that he claimed that he could defeat death herself, because this is what he assumed. For those who read Terry Pratchett, I read, I think, two or three of his work, his books, and La Mort is really wonderful. Vaincre la mort elle-même, so he pretended that he could defeat death himself, herself, because he had killed so many people. He was an expert on the battlefield, and he could actually achieve anything. Un jour, elle lui apparut sur un champ de bataille. One day, she appeared on a battlefield. So he's surprised. And he asks, tu es venu relever mon défi? Demanda-t-il. Did you come to take up my challenge? He asked. One day, she appeared, death appeared on the battlefield. And because he's been claiming that he could defeat death, he thought that death came to actually have a challenge and a battle with him, but she didn't. Well, she would die. She would. She would win anyway. Non, répondit la mort. No, answered death. J'aime simplement remercier les bons employés. I just like to thank my good employees because he had been killing so many people that he sent lots of work for death. And she is happy because he was sending her work. So that's a good way to thank your good employees, though I'm not sure she's such a good employer. Let's read the second one together. And I'm going to put it on another page so we can read much more easily. Lorsque les ordinateurs de bureau devinrent conscients, on demanda aux utilisateurs de ne jamais les éteindre. Mais la nuit, il a un économiseur d'écran très bizarre qui m'empêche de dormir, se plaignit une cliente. Oh, ce n'est pas un économiseur, lui répondit-on, il rêve. Oh, that's cute. Did you understand the tale? So again, when we think about tales, maybe not the first one, but the second one, it opens our minds to new realities. And this is what I love the most about tales. And this is what I discovered, honestly, when we were doing this together, is how much I love tales. And I'm not a big fan of short stories because I prefer to dive for a long time is in longer stories, but such short stories are really cute because in a very short time you can open your mind to new things, and those tales are really lovely. Lorsque les ordinateurs de bureau devinrent conscients, on demanda aux utilisateurs de ne jamais les éteindre. So we have lots of liaison with S here. Les ordinateurs de bureau devinrent conscients. On demanda aux utilisateurs de ne jamais les éteindre. Lorsque les ordinateurs de bureau devinrent conscients. Les ordinateurs de bureau is not a word we use much anymore. We would say les ordinateurs only. So here it is maybe office computers. So it implies that it is not maybe the computers that are hidden in in other objects. It's the real computers that we have that we can touch and have keyboards and screens and everything. But most of the time, we would just say les ordinateurs. Lorsque les ordinateurs de bureau devinrent conscients, became conscious, devenir, it is to become. Devenir, it is to become. On demanda aux utilisateurs de ne jamais les éteindre. Here, the on, it is a generic on. It is not a group of people. Well, at least it is not a defined group of people. It is a group of experts, probably, who know more about computers than most of the other mortals. But here it is a generic on. Un utilisateur, it is a user. Un utilisateur, it is a user. De ne jamais les éteindre, to never turn them off. Les, it is les ordinateurs. We could say de ne jamais éteindre les ordinateurs. We could even say de ne jamais éteindre les ordinateurs. OK? Here it is les ordinateurs de bureau. De ne jamais les éteindre. Éteindre est to switch off. Éteindre. To turn off. And how do you say turn on? It is allumé. And you can apply this to many things, including fire. You can say éteindre un feu, allumer un feu. Je vais éteindre la lumière pendant que tu allumes le feu. And for those who know the song or are curious about songs, Allumer le feu is a song by Johnny Hallyday. Well, it was written by Zazie. She's a French singer and composer and author as well. She's really good. Allumer le feu. Let's read this together and do la liaison, okay? Don't forget it. Lorsque les ordinateurs de bureau devinrent conscients, on demanda aux utilisateurs de ne jamais les éteindre. OK. Mais la nuit, il a un économiseur d'écran très bizarre qui m'empêche de dormir, se plaignit une cliente. Mais la nuit, but at night, we say la nuit for night and le jour for the day. La nuit, le jour. OK. Il a un économiseur d'écran. Un économiseur d'écran is not a word we use much because usually it's just on your computer. It is a screen saver. OK. Just a thing that pops up when your computer is. How do you say en veille? Sleep. Oh, okay. That's funny. We say en veille. I'm going to write it for you. Mon ordinateur se met en veille au bout de 5 minutes sans activité. My computer goes to sleep. Maybe I don't know how you use that, but se mettre en veille is how we say it. After 5 minutes without any activity. Très bizarre. Bizarre is weird. Qui m'empêche de dormir. Empêcher is to prevent someone from doing something, or even yourself. Empêcher de, it is to prevent. For example, j'empêche mon chien de manger les baies du jardin. Elles sont toxiques. So I prevent my dog from eating the, how do you say bay? It's obvious, but I can't remember this one. Not bay. Berries. Yeah, berries. From my garden, it's toxic. You say toxic as well? Toxic, poisonous. Yeah, that's better. Poisonous. So you can do this as in you're doing this on purpose, or it's something that is actually preventing you from sleeping, but it's not on purpose. Or you can, it can be literally, and it can be something that is just psychological. Okay, so it works for many, many, many cases. De dormir from sleeping, se plaignit une cliente. Here we have le passé simple, obviously, and what is the verb of se plaignit? Do you know? It is se plaindre, to complain. Se plaindre, to complain. Une cliente, a customer. We saw this before. We don't have word for customers. We only have a word for client. And client is the translation in French for customer and client in English. Mais la nuit, il a un économiseur d'écran très bizarre qui m'empêche de dormir, se plaignit une cliente. Here, I only see one liaison. Okay. Oh, ce n'est pas un économiseur, lui répondit-on. Il rêve. Oh, it is not a screensaver, someone answered her. Il rêve. It's dreaming. Rêver, it is to dream. So the computer was dreaming. And do we have a liaison here? We do have one. This is not a liaison, by the way, because you have un tiret. So it is a mandatory liaison because you have un tiret. Ce n'est pas un écran. Okay. So let's reread this together and I'm going to translate. One, two, three. Lorsque les ordinateurs de bureau devinrent conscients, on demanda aux utilisateurs de ne jamais les éteindre. When computers became conscious, we asked the users to never turn them off. Okay, so that's surprising because we don't assume the computers are going to become conscious anymore. Do you say sentience? I had heard sentience is something. Aware, conscious. Maybe conscious is what I'm looking for. Conscious. Mais la nuit, il a un économiseur d'écran très bizarre qui m'empêche de dormir, se plaignit une cliente. So here we can assume that at night this computer goes to sleep just like ours do, but this one is so maybe so flashy that the user cannot sleep anymore. And also, we can assume that because the computer became conscious, they might die if you turn them off. So that's really awful. Oh, ce n'est pas un économiseur, lui répondit-on. Il rêve. It is not a screensaver. So what you are used to is not anymore. It's dreaming. It is dreaming. Lui répondit-on. It is, here the lui, it is her. Okay, it is the lady, the user. Répondit-on, it is again une inversion. Because when you are doing this form of telling who is speaking, you have to do une inversion, just like here. Se plaignit une cliente, this doesn't mean anything. It should be une cliente se plaignit. But because you are showing who is speaking, you actually do this inversion. Good. Well done you. That's really good. You've made lots of progress. And I know because I've seen your questions in the chat and your questions are getting better and better. So well done. Tomorrow we're going to talk about time travel and monsters, legendary monsters. So it won't be tomorrow, it will be on Friday. on Friday it will be our last lesson together. So yeah, it's the end of something, but it's the beginning of so many new things, and I will cherish this time together for a long time because it was lovely. And again, we can find a way to make more of those in the future. I'm thinking about several things, and I will let you know as soon as I find a good idea. So have a lovely day, a lovely evening, une bonne journée, bonne soirée, maybe bonne nuit, and I will see you on Friday at 7:15 p.m. Paris time, à vendredi, and à bientôt. Salut.